with SRN News, I'm Rich Thomason. It was a brief appearance, President Trump in court in D.C. entering not guilty pleas to counts of conspiracy and obstruction. Indicted by the Biden Justice Department after challenging the outcome of the 2020 election and refusing to back down. Mr. Trump accusing the Biden team of trying to destroy President Biden's chief rival for the White House.
If you can't beat him, you persecute him or you prosecute him. We can't let this happen in America. Thank you very much.
Mr. Trump's lawyers accuse the administration of trying to stifle political speech. They say the 45th president is being persecuted for exercising his free speech rights. Trump backers question the timing of this indictment and other legal action against the former president and front-running GOP presidential candidate. Also at SRNnews.com, an appeals court is allowing asylum restrictions to temporarily stay in place as the case plays out.
The decision by the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals is a major win for the administration's efforts to maintain order along the U.S.-Mexico border. The new rule makes it extremely difficult for people to be granted asylum unless they first seek protection in a country they're traveling through on their way to the U.S. or apply online. A lower court had found the policy illegal and ordered the government to end its use by this coming Monday. The policy is being challenged by rights groups who say migrants forced to remain in northern Mexico are being endangered. I'm Norman Hall.
In California, two U.S. Navy sailors are accused of spying for China, of plotting to send sensitive defense information to Chinese officials. Robert Bauer is sentenced to death. He's the gunman who stormed a synagogue in the heart of Pittsburgh's Jewish community, killing 11 worshipers back in 2018. On Wall Street right now, Dow futures are down 1 point. NASDAQ futures up 30. S&P futures 5 points higher. This is SRN News.
Hey, this is Deb, and you're listening to Dave Cruz on Beyond the Strange Radio.
They have different categories for these types of things, different levels. An encounter of the first kind, that's when you see a UFO. The second kind is when you see evidence of it, crop circles, radiation. The third kind is when you make contact. But the fourth kind, there's nothing more frightening than the fourth. You see, that one is when they abduct you.
From the haunted landscapes of the South, throughout the ghostly mountains of the Carolinas, this is The Strangest Hour with Dave Cruz. Greetings, everyone, and thank you for joining us tonight. It is Monday, August 7th, 2023, the year of our Lord. We are broadcasting from the Strange Days Media Network and the eTalk Radio Network at eTalk.tv. We have a great show for you tonight, and it's a it's an interesting show. I really tried to plan this show. When I mean plan, I tried to really look into this. And you know, no matter how much I do this, there's going to be people who are just going to be like, why would you choose a topic like this? Well, because it's interesting and it's interesting to me. And, And you'll see in just a little bit. But we have a lot to talk about. But first, please follow me, Dave Cruz, on X, formerly known as Twitter, at Dave70Cruz. That's at Dave70Cruz. Also, like and follow the Beyonders crew on Facebook, where Russ Bailey is the admin. And please visit beyondthestrange.com for all social media links for the show. Remember to follow and like our YouTube and Rumble channels for the show's video archives. Also, you can find more recent and past shows. And you can also now support the show by going to buymeacoffee.com. Go to buymeacoffee.com/BTS show. And all donations go right back into the show. And remember, all links and info for the current and future past shows, as well as guests, are at beyondstrange.com/stream. Upcoming guest this Wednesday, August 9th at 6 p.m. Pacific Time, 9 p.m. Eastern, right here on the Strange Day Media Network, Strange Days Media Network, and eTalk Radio. We'll be having author, researcher, and keynote speaker from Contact in the Desert and other shows like Coast to Coast AM, Beyond Belief with George Norrie, Ancient Aliens. Mr. Brad Olson will be joining me. Brad Olson is an author, researcher, and of many books he's written, the Esoteric series, amongst others. He also owns the CCC Publishing Company, where he publishes books for known authors and researchers like Leon Sagami, soon Laura Eisenhower, and many others. And we will be talking a lot about different things that are in the current news, as well as what to expect in our future. So please don't miss that. That's going to be this Wednesday, August 9th. And all links, of course, just like you found this show, are at beyondstrange.com/stream. And please share the show. If you see the show on your social media feed, share it. You know, it's no big deal. It doesn't cost you anything. You know, it helps us out. Helps grow the show. Creates a bigger chat room. More people can interact. It's good all the way around. So please share the show. As a personal favor, I ask. Thank you. Also, we have upcoming events. Alien Event 2023 will be held this September 14th through the 17th at Alexis Park Resort in Las Vegas. You want to get tickets and more info at alienevent.com. Speakers include Johnny Enoch, Mike Barra, Laura Eisenhower, Dr. Raul Valverde, plus many more. And of course, my guest for this Wednesday, author, researcher, and keynote speaker Brad Olson, will be at this event as well. I got more information about that here in a minute. Let me go through this other event that is very important to me. The 2023 Star Knowledge 1111 conference will be held in Pickstown, South Dakota. It'll also be viewed online. You can get tickets for that as well online. It will be held on November 10th through the 12th. It was founded by Chief Golden Light Eagle, who has passed on. And he also has passed it on to his daughter, Nikki Zephyr, who will also be a guest speaker. The Star Knowledge 1111 conference is about the indigenous elders, wisdom keepers, and visionaries sharing ancient knowledge for the future of Mother Earth. They speak about the star seeds and spirituality and all kinds of esoteric and metaphysical subjects. And you don't want to miss this conference. If you can't make it in person, I highly recommend you get an online ticket so you can watch the conference online. And I'm going to do my best to be there because it's going to be great. Guest speakers include Danion Brinkley, as mentioned, Nikki Zephyr. Stephanie Big Eagle will also be there. She's been very active on Facebook. Thomas Johnson, the Mitchell Hedges Crystal Skull with Bill Haman. And I mentioned Thomas Johnson. He will be going over the Serpent Mound. It's a very fascinating topic. I'm planning on having him on the show very soon before the conference, as well as some other speakers. So you don't want to miss that. So remember, go to www.starknowledge1111.com for more information and details about the conference. And what I wanted to say is, you don't want to miss any shows because I'm going to do my best to get tickets for both of these conferences and give them away to the listeners. So you may have a chance to either get a ticket online or go in person for either of these events. I'm going to do my best to do that. So keep listening to the show, go to the website, follow social media pages for the show my social media. And we'll get more details on getting tickets for these events. You don't want to miss these events. They're going to be amazing. And last but not least, eTalk Radio is having its second Haunted Marathon this year. And the marathon will run the weekend of October 21st and the 22nd with live shows both Saturday and Sunday. Guests are still to be announced, but last year's show, Haunted Marathon, was a major success, and this year's will be no different. It may even be more awesome. I don't know how, but it might just be more awesome. It's totally free, and there will be a live chat at the official eTalk chat room right there on the radio page. It's the only way you're going to be able to listen to the Haunted Marathon is by going to the eTalk.tv/radio page. Of course, there'll be links everywhere. I'll have links on my website. We'll put them in social media, Twitter, X, whatever you want to call it, Facebook, Instagram, that kind of thing. So look out for that. It's going to be a great event. It's fun, and you can hang out with your friends and listen to all the spooky goodness of the Haunted Marathon at eTalk Radio. All right, I do believe those are all the announcements, and so let's go ahead and get into this. Now, remember, I don't really, I've never heard of this, okay? I've never heard of this until recently, but in this picture you see here in the screen, I know those of you who are listening on eTalk can't see this, but maybe I'll put up some pictures on the website. On the Beyond Strange website, I got to make a gallery here pretty soon, so I can do this, so that people can who are listening can go over to the website and they can go to the gallery and look at the images. You know, or you can always go to the website and watch the show there. You don't have to go into Twitch or YouTube or anything. All right, so this is called an oarfish. Okay, like a boat oar for paddling. They're pretty big. An oarfish or a regalecus. I'm doing my best. I know I'm butchering it. Regalecus glesne is a type of deep sea fish known for its long, slender, and ribbon-like body shape. It belongs to the family Reg. I tried to practice these names. They're not easy. I'm just going to stop. And is also sometimes referred to as the king of herrings due to its elongated appearance. Oarfish are rarely seen alive as they inhabit the deep ocean and are not commonly encountered near the surface. Some key characteristics of the oarfish include, of course, we talked about the elongated body. Now, let me see if I can make this picture bigger. I know I can. There we go. Yeah, that's better. All right. So there you go. How many people is that? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 13, 14. It's about 14 people holding up this fish. Maybe 14, between 14 and 16 people holding up this. Looks like a big giant eel, sort of, but it's a fish. It's what it is. And it says here that some specimens reaching up to 30 feet or more. The body is thin and ribbon-like with silvery coloration. Dorsal fin. The fish has a single long dorsal fin that runs almost the entire length of its body, giving it an oar-like appearance. This fin is often mistaken for multiple fins due to its length. The pelvic fins. Oarfish have small pelvic fins, but they lack ventral fins and spines on their dorsal fin. Distribution. Oarfish are found in deep waters around the world, typically at depths of around 200 to 1,000 meters, approximately 6,600 to 3,300 feet. They are most commonly spotted near the surface when they are sick or injured. Remember that. That's kind of key. Due to their elusive nature and deep sea habitat, not much is known about the behavior and biology of the oarfish. They are not considered dangerous to humans as they primarily feed on plankton and small fish. However, their large size and eerie appearance have led to various myths and legends about these creatures throughout history. Oarfish sightings are infrequent and they are most often observed when they are washed ashore or accidentally caught by deep sea fishing nets. Okay, we're going to stop there. The fish itself is, in my opinion, strange enough to be on Beyond the Strange or Strange Talk, whichever program you're watching or listening to right now. In itself, this fish is just cray cray, right? It looks like a sea serpent, you know, in a way. Its own way, it looks pretty prehistoric. What if I were to tell you that this fish may actually be predicting events, namely earthquakes and major earthquakes at that? Yeah, all right. That's what I'm saying. So why don't we go ahead and do this? Kill that. Bring this up on the screen. And I'm going to make this a little bit bigger so hopefully we can all see this a little bit more better. Don't know why it does not want to respond. Okay, hang on one second, people. I'm just trying to make this a little bit bigger so we can all see this better. For some reason, it's just giving me grief. Let's see why that is happening. All right, there we go. Let me get this a little bit bigger. And wow, this is not helping me at all. There we go. All right, so we got this. And we have that. There we go. That's better. All right. No, now I can't really see that, can we? All right, let's just bring this down. Okay. Just for the sake of the show, we're going to do that. Okay, enough of that. Sorry about that, but I want to make sure we can make this a little bit bigger or big enough to see this video. This is what caught my attention. And I've heard this before, but you guys are going to like this, I think. And here we go.
Everyone needs to start preparing for an earthquake or tsunami. At least that's what this oarfish is apparently telling us. This guy was spotted off the coast of Taiwan by some divers, and apparently it's extremely rare to spot an oarfish. They usually live about 200 to 1,000 meters under the sea. These guys are the longest bony fish in the world, and apparently they were referred to as the messenger from the sea god's palace, and they are known to be the bearer of impending doom. According to National Geographic, six of these guys were found in 2017, just days before a deadly earthquake in the Philippines. These guys are pretty elusive, and seeing them along the surface is usually quite rare. They do get washed up once in a while, though. This guy was found in 2013 in California. There was a 50-foot long one found in New Jersey in 1963, and a 600-pound one apparently was found in Maine in 1885. Everyone needs to start preparing for an earthquake or a tsunami.
So, I mean, I don't know, guys. I mean, you know, you guys didn't even get to see that video. I'm so sorry. I'm going to play it one more time just because I apologize. I thought I had it on the other screen and it wasn't on the stream screen. So let me go ahead and do that one more time.
At least that's what this oarfish is apparently telling us. This guy was spotted off the coast of Taiwan by some divers, and apparently it's extremely rare to spot an oarfish. They usually live about 200 to 1,000 meters under the sea. These guys are the longest bony fish in the world, and apparently they were referred to as the messenger from the sea god's palace, and they are known to be the bearer of impending doom. According to National Geographic, six of these guys were found in 2017, just days before a deadly earthquake in the Philippines. These guys are pretty elusive, and seeing them along the surface is usually quite rare. They do get washed up once in a while, though. This guy was found in 2013 in California. There was a 50-foot long one found in New Jersey in 1963, and a 600-pound one apparently was found in Maine in 1885. Everyone needs to start preparing for an earthquake.
Okay, so you were able to see that this time. I apologize. Pretty interesting stats, though. In 2017, six of them were found off the coast of the Philippines, or Thailand, excuse me. And after that, they had the major earthquakes. I believe it's happened more than once, And if they are being washed up now, which I believe they are, then it's probably a good idea to heed that warning. As a matter of fact, why don't we go ahead and see if we can find more information about Orfish and if they actually have been spotted recently. So, January 28, 2023, we have the huge Orfish thought to predict earthquakes discovered washed up on. Now, of course, there is no scientific evidence. Okay. No scientific evidence. If, you know, that proves that, these things are predicting, you know, earthquakes or impending doom or whatever you want to call it. But this particular Orfish, I guess, was found Tansupa Beach, Esmeralda, Ecuador. Huge Orfish thought to predict earthquakes discovered washed up on the beach. The Orfish was first reported sighting in Ecuador this year. When they are seen, it can be caused by storms washing them towards land and believed to be a sign of earthquakes and tsunamis. And, of course, it gives all the stats about, you know, 1,000 feet in the water, blah, blah, blah. And this one says it was first reported sighting of 2023 in South America, Ecuador. And let's see. Second, now it's going. Now what's coming? An earthquake. And then we continue to see. All right. So, I don't know. Got to do some more digging because I don't know if there's been any earthquakes in Ecuador, but there usually is. And, you know, it talks about Orfish resemble sea serpents, that kind of thing. They do say it's a myth, but it says shortly before the disaster, at least a dozen of rarely seen fish washed ashore in Japan in late 2009 and 2010. After the Tohoku earthquake and tsunami. And again, it says in 2022, the Ecuadorian Geophysical Institute said the myth has no validity in any scientific study carried out. Well, you know, maybe they should be doing more studies on this fish. I don't see why it would cause any issues. You know, I'm sure there's somebody willing to fund this kind of a study, because if we can get any kind of warnings before a major earthquake or tsunami, let's say on the coast of Oregon or California or Washington, that would be a great tool to have, right? I'm just saying. So, yeah, it's very, very interesting indeed. But we got more stuff to talk about, and we're just going to go ahead and go into our break right now. And when we come back, we'll get into some more about this fish and other creatures, along with mythical creatures that also predicted impending doom and other, I guess you would say, predictions of the future. So this is The Strangest Hour with Dave Cruz. You're listening to us on Strange Days Media Network and on the eTalk Radio Network. So don't go away. We'll be right back with some more interesting, weird, and strange topics. Right after this, don't go away.
with SRN News, I'm Rich Thomason. There's a new abortion measure in place on Guam.
A federal appeals court has ruled that people seeking medication abortions on the U.S. territory of Guam must first meet for an in-person consultation with a doctor. The nearest physician willing to prescribe abortion medication is an eight-hour flight away from the remote island. A three-judge panel on the Ninth U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals said Guam can enact the laws it thinks are best, even if others find them unwise. 85% of Guam's residents are Catholic. Greg Clugston, SRN News.
The United Arab Emirates has approved release of the Barbie movie after a delay of over a month over possible content issues. The movie's inclusion of a transgender actress as Barbie could be an issue in Arab countries with Muslim majorities that consider homosexuality as well as transgender identity to run contrary to Islamic religious beliefs. This is SRN News.
Hi, this is Jeff Rennell, the host of eTalk TV Live. Tune in every Tuesday as I bring in experts to cover topics like spirituality, metaphysics, UFOs, extraterrestrials, extra-dimensionals, Bigfoot, and everything paranormal.
There's public sparring within Wisconsin State Supreme Court days after the seating of a new justice switched the court to a liberal.
Hi, this is Jeff Rennell, the host of eTalk TV Live. Tune in every Tuesday as I bring in experts to cover topics like spirituality, metaphysics, UFOs, extraterrestrials, extra-dimensionals, Bigfoot, and everything paranormal. So join me here on eTalk Radio every Tuesday night from 7 to 9 Pacific. Don't miss out.
Hi, this is Susan, aka Astro Lunatic, and I am your host for Astro Lunatic's Guide to the Universe, where we look at what the hell is going on in the heavens and what is up your anus. Thanks for joining me on eTalk.tv.
There's public sparring within Wisconsin State Supreme Court days after the seating of a new justice switched the court to a liberal majority.
Wisconsin voters elected former Milwaukee County Judge Janet Protasiewicz to a 10-year term on the state Supreme Court in April, and she was sworn in on Tuesday. Protasiewicz drew Democratic support, making abortion rights and Republican-drawn redistricting maps a focus of her campaign. She changes the court to a 4-3 liberal majority after 15 years of conservative control. 2 days in, Chief Justice Annette Ziegler is accusing her colleagues of a raw exercise of overreaching power after they fired the conservative director of the state's court system, Randy Koshnik, a former judge himself. I'm Jennifer King.
Ukrainian drones have attacked a major Russian port on the Black Sea, damaging a naval ship. It was the latest in a series of strikes inside Russia, as Kiev vows to bring the fight home to Russians. More details, srnnews.com.
Have you ever looked skyward and pondered UFOs, aliens, time travel, alternate universes, and parallel dimensions? Want to explore paranormal activities, hauntings, and various cryptids such as Bigfoot, sea, and lake monsters? Greetings, Beyonders. I'm author Casper Parks, and you're listening to Beyond the Strange with host Dave Cruz. Help spread the word by posting links to forums and social media. Available at YouTube, Spreaker, iTunes, Stitcher, and TuneIn Radio.
Welcome back. This is The Strangest Hour with Dave Cruz, right here on the Strange Days Media Network and eTalk Radio on eTalk.tv. And we've been discussing the possibility of, you could say psychic fish, or maybe not. There's really no scientific evidence that shows that this fish is psychic, other than the fact that it's either injured or dies before earthquakes and tsunamis and, you know, that kind of thing. So in a way in itself, I mean, it is a bit of a harbinger, if that's how you pronounce the word, harbinger, of impending doom when it comes to these kind of catastrophes. And so the reason why I brought it up was because of a video that I saw on TikTok. And you know, I looked a little bit more into this, and it's very interesting to be a bearer of impending doom, this fish. So let's go ahead and get back to the live screen. For those of you who are watching either on the BTS stream page, the beyondthestrange.com/stream page, where you can watch the show without having to sign in or do anything, or listening on eTalk Radio right now. So, anyways, here it is again, the video of the oarfish.
Earthquake or tsunami. At least everyone needs to start preparing for an earthquake or tsunami. At least that's what this oarfish is apparently telling us. This guy was spotted off the coast of Taiwan by some divers, and apparently it's extremely rare to spot an oarfish. They usually live about 200 to 1,000 meters under the sea. These guys are the longest bony fish in the world, and apparently they were referred to as the messenger from the sea god's palace, and they are known to be the bearer of impending doom. According to National Geographic, six of these guys were found in 2017, just days before a deadly earthquake in the Philippines. These guys are pretty elusive, and seeing them along the surface is usually quite rare. They do get washed up once in a while, though. This guy was found in 2013 in California. There was a 50-foot long one found in New Jersey in 1963, and a 600-pound one apparently was found in Maine in 1885. Everyone needs to...
There's the different dates. It's, you know, it's one of the reasons why people are looking at this fish, and they're saying that this fish can be a harbinger. This fish can be telling us that, you know, there's impending earthquakes or tsunamis, because they don't normally rise to the surface. And when they do, they're either injured or they're dead, probably because of what's going to happen with the earth as far as earthquakes, you know, natural disasters, that kind of thing. So I don't know. I just thought it was really interesting and quite possibly important when it comes to, you know, this kind of a phenomenon. You know, if there's going to be an earthquake or a tsunami, it could be a big one and very, very dangerous and catastrophic. So why not pay attention to this oarfish? You know, it's actually kind of interesting and cool looking, but I don't know if I'd want to eat that. Doesn't look appetizing to me. It looks like a big giant sardine. I don't know. Anyways, but that's the oarfish. And there are other animals that have been known to predict let's see if I can find it, events. And so, you know, we can go ahead and read those off, but this comes from KaboomTech.com, and you know, talking about science, it says, can animals predict future events? Animals are important factors in our lives, and they have the same rights as us on Earth. Animals of all kinds lived freely in nature until some of them went extinct. Since they are more connected to nature and the Earth itself, they may have the ability to feel when something is going to happen in terms of nature, like an earthquake or a storm. There are a lot of animals that have this gift, and you may think that the stories from the last part of the article are not true. It talks about cats. You know, a cat can't usually, excuse me, a cat can't actually tell the future with their senses, but can hear, smell, and see better than a human. So its reaction can show us something that we don't know already. Maybe they know or can feel more than we think. We will never know. They are cats. I don't know who writes this stuff. But they make a good point, because in the paranormal, of course, cats are often linked to their owners that are either living in a haunted, you know, quote, haunted, unquote, home. And, you know, if you look at a cat, or if you take a video of a cat, you know, and the house is said to be haunted, sometimes you'll see cats looking up in the air like they're looking at a person, or they get really scared and they run off for no apparent reason. So, yeah, they definitely have, you know, higher sense and maybe hearing, smell, touch, that kind of thing, and sense than humans. So, sure. I mean, you know, I'm sure they could predict or at least know when something else is happening on our planet. So there you go. Dogs. Dogs are man's best friend since forever. And this actually is a true fact due to the loyalty and protection that the dog gives us, besides that a dog's energy is higher and more developed, and they can predict human illness or even death. This type of detection is based on the energy and emotions a human has, because dogs feel them. It's been known that dogs can sometimes tell when its owner is having a heart attack, or if, you know, something's happened to the owner and, you know, there's no one around. So the dog acts, you know, crazy and probably tries to go get help. So yeah, dogs are, I love dogs. You know, what can I say? Dogs are amazing. And, I think they should be treated more than just, you know, as a cow or whatever. Anyway, all animals should be treated, you know, with respect, I guess. But, you know, for me, you know, dogs are pretty awesome, and cats are too. I love cats too. So, nice to have them around, because you never know. You might actually want to have them around in case something like a tornado is coming or something like that. They're good pets to let you know that something's happening or about to happen. Groundhogs, right? Groundhogs, the most popular animal known for predicting weather is obviously the groundhog. The people are heading to Pennsylvania every year on February 2nd to find out if Punxsutawney Phil is predicting 6 more weeks of winter or there will be an early spring. It says here, if the chubby little prophet comes out of his hole and sees his shadow, he will retreat and there will be 6 more weeks of winter weather. If otherwise, there will be an early spring. And like in every event, you need competition. George's own weather predicting groundhog is General Beauregard Lee. PolitiFact decreed a winner in 2011 showed that General Lee is more accurate, 60% for early springs compared to Phil's 39%. 60% General Lee. That's pretty funny. Okay. Butterflies and bees. If butterflies and bees disappear from its flower bed, then there are high chances for a rainstorm to come. Unfortunately, you can see them only on summer days. So that's, I don't know. I haven't encountered that, but since I've been here in South Carolina, it's been raining like crazy. Like every other day, it just doesn't rain either. It storms and it pours. So I don't think I've ever heard lightning and thunder I heard thunder and seen lightning like I have here in South Carolina. It's quite a show. Definitely, you know, should check it out one of these days. If you're in South Carolina, just go outside and check it out. It's pretty nuts. But it pours like crazy, man. And it's really warm and muggy. That I'm still trying to get used to. But anyways, it is what it is. Ladybugs. The folklore stories say that if you see ladybugs around you, that means the good weather is near you. If it's the other way around, you may expect some cold or rainy times. So ladybugs are also, these aren't animals, these are insects, right? I mean, what's going on here? Ants. Ants have developed sensitive antennae and can detect with them falling barometric pressure caused by the rains. It has been observed that some species, even 24 hours before rainfall, have started to build water barriers around the nest to prevent water from flooding the colony. Fire ants survive a flood by forming a raft by crossing their legs. In this, they can float above the water for days or even weeks. How interesting is that? They cross their legs and pretty crazy. All right. Ah, here we go. Sheeps. When sheep gather in a huddle, tomorrow we'll have a puddle. Interesting. That's pretty cute. Maybe you heard this phrase at least once. Maybe not. It may not be 100% accurate weather indicator, but the rhyme is cute. Another way people find out that they're going to get heavy rain in Iceland, people think that if their sheep urinate more often, it means bad weather is coming. But it doesn't have a solid base, of course. Ah, sharks are also predictable animals. Sharks are also smart animals when it comes to predicting bad weather. And scientists have proved the fact that sharks swam into much deeper water to be protected by storms. The study was done on a group of black-tip sharks, which responded to falling barometric pressure caused by the storm. There you go. Sharks. Cows. Farmers know it better. When their cows are laying down, the heavy rain, it's a-coming. A recent study at the University of Arizona shows that a cow, when laying down or lying down, it conserves heat before the rain is coming, usually with the drop in temperature. So there you have it. It's not being lazy, you know, people. It's because it's waiting for the rain to show up. So there you go. Birds. The birds may be great at predicting the future. These are studies on birds that migrate to see how they can figure out which of their paths are tornadoes or storms. A reason this forecast happens is possible to be their infrasound perception, or they just know, depending on the season, which way the bad weather goes. I'm so sorry, I'm reading terribly tonight. If you can't tell, I'm feeling a little under the weather. I almost feel like I'm coming down with something, probably like a flu or something, but hopefully it's nothing serious. I've had my fair share of crappy feeling over the last couple of weeks. It says, if you see many birds straddling power lines, sudden migration or seagulls flying in from the coast, it means that maybe a rainstorm is coming. Right? And then it goes on to say, why do animals have strange behavior before earthquakes? Well, any animal can definitely feel an earthquake faster than any human being. Like a sixth sense, thunders and earthquakes emit infrasound sound waves with a frequency that human ears can't perceive, but animals can. People, since the old days, have discovered strange behavior in animals. Before a bad event, an earthquake shook a city in ancient Greece thousands of years ago, and records from that time report the fact that animals ran from the cities in herds. In China, animals saved a lot of lives by predicting a 7.3 magnitude earthquake that happened in 1975 in Haisheng. The animals from the city had an unusual behavior And that was the moment when the Chinese authorities evacuate 1 million people a few days before the earthquake. People told how the chickens refused to enter the coops, cows and horses were restless, and ducks were agitated. Also, the rats and snakes on the roads appeared to be frozen. In 2004 in Sri Lanka, elephants ran to higher grounds and dogs wouldn't go outside and flamingos fled to the beaches. Shortly after people saw this, a tsunami hit the island. Unfortunately, that wasn't enough. The tsunami was too powerful and killed hundreds of thousands of people, unfortunately. Animals can't really tell the future, but some of them have more developed and sharper senses that show us nature-related events before we realize what's happening. So there you go. It's not exactly magical or psychic abilities or anything like that, but it's pretty close to it. Pretty strange stuff. You got the oarfish, you got a lot of these different animals that now I did have information about other mythical creatures. I believe dragons, maybe, and centaurs. Dragons and centaurs were known to link to be oracles of consciousness or the future or whatever. But they're mythical, so it doesn't really matter. I think it's interesting also that they mentioned that about those mystic, mythical creatures that can predict the future and that kind of thing. So, anyways, I thought that was pretty interesting. Wanted to share that with you guys and, just hang out with you guys. And hopefully you guys are enjoying the subject matter and topics. We'll be doing more shows in the future. I got, like I said, Brad Olson's going to be my guest Wednesday night, August 9th. And you don't want to miss that. That's going to be a great show. Those conferences that I mentioned also before, they're going to be great. You don't want to miss that. Just keep coming to the website and check it out. It's we got a lot of good stuff coming, so thanks for showing up tonight. I greatly appreciate that, and remember to keep looking to the sky. I don't want to go there. Just stay strange, everyone. Okay. For the strangest hour, I'm Dave Cruz. Thank you for listening, and we will see you next time right here on the Strange Days Media Network and eTalk Radio, right here at eTalk.tv. Thank you. Have a good night, and hasta.